Yes, so my name is Robert, and I'm going to talk about some introduction for Rad Studio and its C++ builder. Yeah, we have someone. No, so that's my second slide, actually. Yeah. So, anyone knows what embarcadero is? Yeah, now we, yeah, that was my second question. How many of you know Borland? You're over 40, I'm sure. So that's, yeah, so if you're familiar to that box, or maybe this is, yeah, that's some old stuff. So, yeah, so then I think you know what this is about. So this is actually the Rad Studio. Rad Studio is actually two products. It's Delphi, I'm sure someone has worked with that, and the C++ Builder. Actually, now it's happening a lot with this C++ Builder because it's going to support C++ 17, and yeah, and they actually released a new version with C++ 17 yesterday. So it's, but I don't going to cover that. I think that's going to be the next talk, maybe. Yes. So actually, the Rad Studio, yeah, is it a web developer tool? It's like a traditional like Visual Studio. So you have like the design, you have like drag and drop components, and I think the strongest thing is like it's like cross-platform. So you can also do cross-platform apps, and I'm not going to so much into the details, but you have the it's a good debugger with the like conditional breakpoints, and you can deploy. From the tool directly to the mobile store, App Store, Play Store, and also I think in, I don't know exactly what the name is, in the Windows 10 store, I think it's maybe called Windows 10 store. And they have a traditional collaboration tool, it's support of Git and Subversion. And you have a package handler, so there are some, you can download the package. It's not so much like the Visual Studio, but it's, you can find lots of good thing there. It's also good for like Internet of Things. You have like iBeacons and Bluetooth directly. You have components for that. So it's kind of good integration. So actually it's the tool are, you can do like the VCL components. So it's like traditional Windows program, and that's yeah the basic stuff. It support, I seen the videos of the new version. It's kind of interesting, but it supports lots of new things, high DPI screens and everything. So it's it's up to date actually. And then it's this FireMonkey part. So that's the multi-platform. It's like the Visual Studio Xamarin, if you've heard about that. So it's like you're developing multi-platform application. You can run it on Windows and Android and iOS. And also, I think you can also do it in the Linux, but it's not so much GUI stuff, but in the, you can do. So that they are involving that. You're also, the components are actually, you can, the program can render the components or you can use the native components. So it depends on what component you're using. You can let the program render or just use the native components. So I'm going not so much into this, but I'm sure you're interested in this stuff. It's for now, since yesterday, they are C++ 17, but the version I have and I'm going to show is C++ 11. So you can use Clang and CMake, and this is the LLVM. I'm sure you also know what that is. I think that's a common thing they use. So it's a good infrastructure. I think they are doing a good job. So I need to do some demo, or I want to do a demo. Yeah, this is my son Dennis, and he's on in the top of a mountain called Kjerksbolten in Norway. That was something I want to show you. So I'm going to switch to the demo. So I'm running a Mac, and I have a virtual machine, VMware, because if I want to develop on iOS devices, you need to have like a platform assistant that you compile to. So you need to install a bit of software in your Mac to compile to iOS. So I prepared an easy application. So you have a traditional, going to can close this one. If you want to see the code, so this is only 3 lines of code. So you have, I'm using the component because it's quite easy, and the components are like clever. So you don't. So if you have a component for a camera, you can use a prepared component, and it's going to show the button if it's a camera or not in the hardware. So it's kind of good to use the prepared components. So as you see, it's like a very basic Hello World application, 3 lines of code. So I'm going to see if I go back again. Oh, it's a little bit hard to see the all the. I can look here maybe. Oh, it's there. Yes. So it's a traditional tool. You have your CPP file and H file, and you also, I think the strongest thing is you have also, you can actually do like a preview. So you have like, if you want to, it looks like an iOS device, and you can also, if you have an Android device, you can like a preview. You can also, if you want, I want to see it in an iPhone, how it's looking on an iPhone. So it's quite good and easy to, and you can also move around, so you can have different layout for different devices. So hopefully they're going to support more devices. And I'm going to quit. And the strongest thing is when you can see here, you have the platform you can compile to. So it's 32-bit Windows, 64, and you have Android, and you have 32-bit iOS device. I don't think they use that anymore, but and also Mac OS X. So if we take like a 32-bit, I'm going to switch that one. So it's just if you compile it, it's going to run like a regular exe file, and you can do some testing you want. So that's quite neat when you doing debugging and stuff. So if I want to, I just switch now to the iOS device, and then it's going to take a bit longer. Now it's used the platform assistant in the background, so it's using that one. And actually I have connected my iPhone here, so it's not it's the real stuff. So,
very big iPhone.
Okay, I use it. Yes, so it's compiling. Yeah, so the virtual machine is not super fast, but so hopefully it's going to start. So now it's starting, and it looks like the screen actually. So you have the black and the red, and you can press on here, and we can take some picture of you and use picture, and we can share it. So I'm going to put it. So this is the prepare function. So everything is prepared, and just go in here. I can send it, and also I can show it here if I then switch to Android target and run it on my Android. It's not so nice to see that's compiling, but actually it's quite handy if you want to do just use C++ and platform, cross-platform. Oh, so we can see. So I have also a traditional Android phone here. So it's making this APK file, and it's also going to compile. So now it's starting up, and now you have the Android look and feel. So you have the icons are now for the Android. So it's quite easy to do this compiling. So actually, I'm going to do this. So actually, it's if you want to use C++, and you will build native app and do some cross-platforming, and you do everything right with the certificate and everything, all the cables and everything, then it feels like this. So that was my talk.